Hello children, good morning everyone. Today in this lecture I am going to explain you about the power and function of the parliament. Whatever given in your book power and function, these are very less. Still then whatever given in your book, that much is enough for your class 8. So directly you can write from your book also, point wise given, no problem. So I am going to explain that one, watch it. Powers and functions of the parliament. The parliament of India has a multifunctional role in the administration of the country. It performs several functions like legislative function, executive function, financial function, judicial function, electoral function and constitutional function. Let us discuss these functions one by one. Legislative function. What are the legislative function of the parliament? Legislative function, first point. The parliament has the power to make laws on any subject mentioned in the union list, concurrent list and the residuary list. First point. Second point, under special circumstances and with the consent of the Rajya Sabha, it can also legislate on the subjects of the state list. These two points you have to write in the legislative function. So children, parliament has the power to make laws on almost all subjects. Executive function. The executive remains accountable to the Parliament of India for its every policy or action. Executive completely responsible to the Parliament for its every policy and action. The Parliament can discuss and question any policy of the government by passing various motions like adjournment motion, call attention motion, censure motion, no confidence motion, etc. It can reject or amend a money bill despite the opposition by the cabinet. It can reject or amend a money bill. It can appoint committees to scrutinize the functioning of the government. It can even expel the government by passing the no confidence motion. So these are the five executive functions whatever mentioned in your book. Executive function, 5 points you have to write. If you cannot understand any one of the point also, you can send comment or send message in my WhatsApp number. Financial function. The parliament has complete control over the finance of the country. Every year the government is supposed to present an annual budget in the parliament. Annual budget is the estimate of annual income and expenditure of the country. And along with this, the railway budget, general budget, railway budget, all budgets, it is the responsibility of the government to present. The parliament is empowered to suggest amendments, pass or reject the presented budget by the government. The parliament also grants money to the government for the concerned financial year. No taxes can be levied, abolished
or replaced without the permission of the parliament. And last, the parliament also appoint the financial committees to inquire into the expenditure made by the government and report on the working of the finance department. So these are the 5 points, financial functions. Once again, repeating the points. The parliament present the annual budget of the country. Secondly, it is empowered to suggest amendments of the constitution or pass or reject the presented budget by the government. It can pass also the budget, or it can reject also the budget presented by the government in the parliament. The parliament also grants money to the government for the concerned financial year. No taxes can be levied, abolished or replaced without the permission of the parliament. That means not a single penny can be invested by the government without the permission of the parliament. The parliament also appoint the financial committees. Parliament can appoint a financial committee to inquire into the expenditure made by the government, whether they have expended those money in proper way or not, and report on the working of the finance department. These are the 5 financial functions. You have to make a number of financial functions, separate functions, legislative function separate number, executive function separate, and financial function separate. Judicial function: on account of the violation of the Constitution of India or misuse of power, the parliament is empowered to remove the President of India. The Vice President of India, and at the same time, it can also remove the judges of the Supreme Court and High Courts. This is the judicial function of Parliament, and it can remove the President or Vice President by a process or procedures called impeachment process. Impeachment process is a procedure through which the president can be removed, the vice president can be removed. And the parliament can remove the judges of Supreme Court and High Court. The parliament has also power to remove the Chief Election Commissioner and the Controller and Auditor General of India if they are found guilty of violating provisions of the Constitution. Electoral function. What are the electoral functions? The Indian Parliament has to perform certain electoral duties, electoral functions. They are: the Parliament of India participates in the election of the president along with the state legislatures, and it also participates in the election of the vice president of India, because vice president of India is elected by both the houses of the parliament. President is elected by an electoral college which consists of the members of parliament and the elected members of all state legislature. It can also make laws in order to regulate election of the President of India, Vice President of India, Union and state legislature. So these are the electoral function of the parliament. Constitutional function, the parliament can also amend the constitution of India as long as the desired amendment does not breach the basic structure of the constitution. Okay children, these are the power and functions of the parliament. If you are having any doubt or confusion, you can send me message in my WhatsApp number. No need to worry about any confusion. Okay, thank you children.